YouTube. This is Rebecca the Diva coming at y'all with yet another video. But first and foremost, if you are new to this channel, thanks for stopping by. All I ask you to do is please subscribe to my channel. I promise you, you won't be disappointed. Also, hit that like button, hit that share button, and also leave a comment down below for your girl. And if you are not new, welcome back, Diva Gang. Well, today is going to be considered my Vlogmas number 9, and I will be doing number 10 also, I promise you guys. Excuse my appearance, I had to lay my hair down and put my stocking cap on it, and then I put the bonnet over it because I just want to film with my stocking cap. I do have a couple of hair videos that I have to record and get out today because I'm on a deadline with those videos. So that's the reason why I'm looking crazy. Today is, what today is? The 10th, I believe, and it is in the morning. Yeah, it's 10:30 in the morning. I haven't had breakfast as of yet, and I'm just gonna jump right into this video. So I was like, you know what, I'm craving some shrimp, but not just any type of shrimp. What I'm gonna prepare, this is a cook with me, so what I'm gonna prepare for you guys today, for myself today, is called BANGBANG shrimp. Now, there's a restaurant by the name of BONEFISHGRILL, and on Wednesdays they have $5 or $6 appetizers, and they're called BANGBANG shrimp. They're shrimp and they're covered in this like yummy sauce or whatever, and honey, let me tell you, them shrimp are bomb. And what made me want to make this recipe, because I made it last month in November, so what made me want to make this recipe was my boyfriend had a, some type of food bazaar, potluck thingy, I guess, where food trucks were there at his job, like right before Thanksgiving. And he had brought home these two po' boy sandwiches, shrimp po' boy sandwiches. And oh my God, the shrimp in that sandwich tasted just like these BANGBANG shrimp. So I was like, you know what? I can make these shrimp. So I just went on YouTube, looked up a recipe, and I made it. And like me, my daughter, my boy, we was like grubbing. Like, this is so good. And that's what I got a taste for this one. I was going to make it last night, but I totally got sidetracked being on the phone. And by the time I looked up, it was 11 o'clock, so I really didn't eat anything last night. So I'm going to make this for my breakfast, lunch, brunch for today. And this is going to be my only meal today until tonight. I already had a cup of coffee, which... almost finished with that. I'll probably have another one, but I'm gonna get into this video. So what we're gonna use for this recipe is, you're gonna have to have your shrimp. Okay, this is about probably about a pound of shrimp. Like I said, I took them out last night, and I was going to cook this last night, but I was just really super tired. Okay, I'm gonna bowl to put my shrimp in, and then you're going to basically just season up. I'm not going to season the shrimp per se, but I'm going to season up my egg mixture. So you're just going to use eggs, and then in my eggs I'm going to put Old Bay seasoning, some regular ground black pepper, and some garlic powder. And I'm going to put that inside the eggs for the seasoning. And I'm also, and then once you make your egg mixture and you put your shrimp in the egg mixture, you're just going to toss your egg washed shrimp in some flour. And I'm also going to put the same seasoning inside of my flour. And then once you do that, you're going to just deep fry your shrimp. And then the actual sauce that goes on the shrimp to give it that bang bang is sriracha chili sauce and Thai style sweet chili sauce. And I'm missing the most important ingredient. Let me go in the fridge here. It's mayo. So this is gonna make your bang bang sauce. The mayo, the chili sauce, and the sriracha sauce. You mix those three ingredients and that's how you get your sauce. And then to top it all off, me personally, I'm just going to use some green onions to sprinkle on top, and that's just some chopped green onions, and that's it. And so let me just jump right into this video. I'm going to lower my tripod a little bit so I can kind of focus on getting everything in there, because like I told y'all before, my other Cook With Me video, I am really bad at videography. I know nothing. I'm trying, so bear with me, okay guys? and then we can get this show on the road so you won't see me probably throughout the rest of this video. But I did want to come on and announce myself. Let's do that. Okay, so first thing that I'm going to do is get my egg mixture going here. I'm just going to use 2 large eggs. Crack these up in the bowl. I'm going to try to talk to you guys through this video. Okay, I'm just going to whisk these eggs up. These are just regular eggs. I'm just going to beat them up. And I'm going to add my seasonings. And I'm not going to put a lot because I don't want it to end up being too salty or whatever. I'm also going to try to do a mukbang for you guys. I bought some seafood. I went to the grocery store the other day. I bought some seafood. So I got some lobster tails. I got some crab legs, some shrimp, big jumbo colossal shrimp. So I'm going to try to do that. I don't know when, though. So don't count me on that. But we're just going to stir this all up together. And then once you get your eggs all mixed up, that's all it just looks like. Simple egg mixture. And then I'm going to take my flour, my little baggie of flour, and I'm going to put some of these same seasonings inside of the flour. So that way the outside of the shrimp is going to have some flavor to it. Because when I first fixed them, the first batch that I ever fixed, it didn't have flavor. The coating, the breading on the shrimp didn't really have flavor. And I didn't use a lot of sauce on mine because I didn't know how I was going to like the sauce. I'm just going to shake this up and mix all the seasonings in with that flour. We're going to set that aside. Now I'm going to mix up my sauce. Let me get a spoon. I try to have everything near me. It's kind of hard for me to walk around with my bad hip. But I'm trying, y'all. Y'all got to bear with me. And I'm not really measuring anything. I've been cooking since I was 9 years old. So I eyeball everything. So basically, you probably use like, it's just me here. So I'm not going to even put a lot, but if you're making for a lot of people, you can use a half a cup to a cup of mayo, depending on the size of the people that you're feeding. Me, I got like two tablespoons of mayo in there. That's it. Because like I said, it's just right now, it's just me here. There's no one else that's going to eat shrimp. My 2 kids that are here with me, they don't eat shrimp. So they don't eat seafood. Yeah, they're weird. And then you're just going to put your sriracha in there with the mayo. So you're just going to, and I kind of use a bit because I want mine to be spicy. I need that zing. I need that. Yeah. And then you're going to put your Thai chili sauce, the sweet Thai chili sauce. And I put just as much so that way it can be balanced out. See? I'm trying to get this at a good angle. Like I said, I'm bad as being a videographer. And basically, you just stir that on up. Stir that on up. And you're going to keep stirring and keep stirring because you want to get that mayo and the 2 sauces mixed up where you're not tasting. Because the first time, like I said, the first time I made this, it was mainly like the sauce was too mayo-y. It tastes too much like mayonnaise. So I had to keep adding and keep adding each one of the sriracha and the chili sauce, you know, till I got the right balance. I'm just going to keep stirring this, keep stirring this, keep stirring this, keep stirring this. I'm just going to taste that. Perfect. Wash my hands. Alright, so our sauce is out of the way, our egg mixture is out of the way. What I'm going to do next is these shrimp are deveined, but they're not peeled. So what I'm going to do is go off camera and prepare these shrimp. And then I'll come back and show you how I dip them in the egg and then in the flour and then deep fry them up, okay? So stay tuned for the next part of this video. Okay, guys, I am back. My shrimp are all peeled and washed and everything. So my next step is I am going to take a couple of shrimp. We're going to do like a few at a time. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We're going to just do 6 at a time because I'm using a little tiny pot to deep fry them in because I don't have a deep fryer. My hands are clean. Just reassuring you guys that. The egg off of my hands. And then what I'm going to do is just, after you drop your shrimp in the egg mixture, I just stir it around a little bit just to make sure the shrimp get coated. And guys, you can use any size shrimp that you want. I'm using large because I'm greedy. I prefer the larger ones. So I'm just going to put the shrimp in, the egg coated shrimp, inside of this baggie that I have the flour mixture in. And this is a real easy, simple recipe. It looks like it's a lot, but it's really quick and simple. Like, this can be done under 20 minutes. And I'm just shaking the flour. Then I'm going to turn you guys around to my little stove. There you go. You can see my little red pot with my oil. And you can use any type of oil, cooking oil that you want. I personally use canola oil and only canola oil for everything that I fry down, for my chicken, my fish, whatever it is that I'm going to fry, french fries, shrimp. I use canola oil because canola oil is heart healthy. Just a little tip for you. All right. Now I just take my little shrimp and I take it out the little bag and I just shake off the little excess flour. And as you can see, this is how it looks. Going in, and I'm just going to drop it. And I've already preheated my oil, okay? And you can hear it sizzling. I'm just going to drop them one in. And you just want to cook them, I want to say, 3 minutes on each side, because you know shrimp cook very easily and you don't want to overcook them, because then shrimp gets kind of chewy and then you don't want to have your fire up too high. I got my medium to high heat because what will happen is your shrimp will cook too quickly and then it'll be burnt on the outside, or crispy and dark on the outside, and then on the inside your shrimp are not all the way cooked through. Let me wash this cook off my hands. So yeah, I just let mine cook 3 to 4 minutes on each side. And I got my little fry thingy, scoop them out with. And I just stir them around as they're cooking, just so they can get evenly, you know, in there. And like I said, this recipe, I'm planning on serving it Christmas afternoon, because I know there's like a lot of ball games and stuff like that that come on that my boyfriend and my son may want to watch. My son's not going to eat this, so we'll give him something else. Like I said, my son is vegan, so he ain't going to do this. But my boyfriend does love shrimp, and so do I. So I'll probably make some of this as an appetizer, just to have to snack on before we eat dinner. I don't really know what we're going to fix on Christmas. If my daughter is here, both of them, I'll probably get like a small ham for them and make some baked macaroni cheese, greens, that whole type of thing, situation going on. My boyfriend had said that he wanted some seafood for Christmas, so me and him will probably end up doing that. And if the older girls want to chip in, they can chip in. If not, it is what it is. The younger kids don't eat seafood, so that's that. So they're cooking. I'm about to take them out because they crisp up really well. I don't know whether you guys can see that or not. That's how that's looking. Oh yeah, these are about ready to come out. Like I said, shrimp, they cook really fast. And the smaller the shrimp, the faster it'll cook. And like I said, these are large shrimp that I got. And I just get the regular shrimp that's in the little frozen section and the seafood section in Walmart. Because I think the large ones are like $5.46. And the mediums are $5.44. The small ones are $5. Them small ones, it's like I literally would have to. I'm greedy. I'm a big bitch, okay? I literally would probably have to eat the whole bag of a small size shrimp. So I'm going to take these out. Well, these are large, and I'm just going to fix these six right here and then plate them up so you guys can see how they look. I'm going to just let that drain off for a few minutes. And I'm going to go get a plate. Alrighty, I got my little paper plate here because I don't like to do dishes. And now that these are drained off a little bit, we're just going to put them in the plate. Like I said, I just cooked six just for this little recipe. And like I said, depending on the size of your party or whatever, you can fix as many or as little as you want. I'm going to turn you guys back around. Well, you can see that. They're on this plate. And then what I'm going to do here is I got my little sauce here. And I'm just going to drizzle a little bit on each shrimp. Just like that. Just drizzle it over the shrimp. Yeah, I like mine saucy. So that's what we're doing. And I'm going to take just a little bit of the green onion. And the green onion, you can leave that part out. Some people put chives. Some people do green onion. And I just do the green onion just as a little decoration. That's all. Just a garnishment for the shrimp. And there you have it, guys. Bang Bang shrimp. From Bonefish Grill, made the homemade way. I'm trying to get it in the camera so you guys can see, and it smells so good. And just a side note, guys, this Bang Bang shrimp sauce reminds me of Big Mac sauce. So if you ever went to McDonald's and had a Big Mac, this is kind of sort of what that sauce tastes like, except for the heat. You know, because it is kind of spicy. Like I said, I got mine really spicy because I want that zing. But thank you guys for bearing with me through this Cook With Me video. I promise you guys, I'm going to get more organized when it comes to doing these videos. Please don't forget to thumbs up this video. Please don't forget to share and leave a comment down. I'm going to leave all the ingredients and directions in the description box, okay? I ain't going to leave y'all hanging. So until next time, guys, bye. Okay, guys, here's the finished product up close. Once again, this is Bang Bang Shrimp. It's an appetizer served at the restaurant Bonefish Grill. So I hope you guys enjoyed this cook with me. And like I said, all the ingredients and the directions will be in the description box. Thank you so much. And please don't forget to like this video and subscribe. Until next time, bye guys.